Hi guys, welcome to Thrustzone.com. This is Mohit Soni. Right in front of you is a car that needs no introduction. This is the Mahindra Thar. We've seen it over the decades. We've seen it in multiple forms and shapes. It has been designed again and again over the last couple of decades. But it's been a car that has been updated not so frequently. It happens only once a decade. So this is the decade where we're getting the Mahindra Thar. We've seen multiple spy shots, heard so many things, but it's finally here. We are finally reviewing and experiencing the Mahindra Thar. This is going to be our first impressions because we have limited time with this car. What we know so far is the fact that this is a highly, extremely well designed and completely new inside out, be it the chassis, be it the design, be it the suspension, be it the interior, be it the features. Mahindra has incorporated almost everything it has into this car to make sure the Thar is finally practical. It's a lifestyle vehicle, you can live with it on a daily basis and do the hardcore off-roading that it's always been known for. The design, as you can see, very boxy. But there is something that you don't know probably by now, the fact that this is a sub 4 meter car. Well, yes, this is the car that is falls in the same bracket as the Ford EcoSport and the Mahindra XUV 300 of cars like this. And this is also a full size SUV with ladder on frame. All the off-roading hardware in the world has been put inside this car. What you can see here is this massive 18 inch wheel. This is giving the car the off-road look and the legendary iconic look that it's always been known for. That is the Thar badging on the tail lamp. Mahindra does this with most of its car now. It's been doing here as well. Since we are at the back, let me show you what the boot is like. And this is how you can, yes, open the tail entirely. That's the kind of space you're getting here with the second row of seats up. Close it like this. There's a very heavy door at the back. Again, a good look at the side profile. It does look like the Thar, but obviously everybody on the internet has been calling it the baby Wrangler because the way the front end design has been done. That's what you do to cars to make them modern, to make them fit all the regulations that are strict regulations that are in order nowadays for most cars. But you can see at the front here, I love the way this has been DRL has been incorporated here. These large headlamps, these are not LEDs, but still halogen lamps here. We've got fog lamps here as well. And what you see here open is the clamp. That's how you open it. Then you open the hole like this. And that's the engine. Diesel, 2-liter. We have the manual with us today. So we'll be driving that and letting you know more about it. That's how you close the clamps. And again, time to admire the design that Mahindra has done here. I think it looks spectacular. It's a sub 4 meter SUV with this kind of proportions. It's just something out of the ordinary here, quite literally. But you also get this massive 4x4 badging, Mahindra Thar badging on the inside. There's quite a lot of badging here. As you can see, Mahindra thing, the M-Walk badging here, the embossing here. Getting inside, at least the passengers would be able to see this plate here, which says made in India with pride. This doesn't have a serial number or anything. I'm assuming this is a car which is not for customers yet. But obviously this car is ready, pretty much ready for its launch. It's just that it doesn't have a serial number because it's a test car from Mahindra. Overall, I think the design looks spectacular. Now let's get on the inside. What you can see is an entirely new interior. The new steering wheel inspired from the cars that Mahindra has in its portfolio. In terms of features, let's begin with showing you height adjustable seats at the front. That's how you stuff inside here. That's how you remove the door. It's got this flap. The doors are removable, and as you can see, the hinges are on the outside. I wish this plastic would have been a bit more better. It does feel robust, but I think it could have been a bit better. Getting inside, what you can see, there's no start stop button. You have the keyhole is illuminated, and getting inside is always a dramatic move. What you see are the new dials, which are inspired from cars in the Mahindra stable right now. And that is the screen. Works really well. We first saw it in the XUV 500. I thought the system back then was also good. This is also even better. You've got navigation, you've got all the connectivity options. You can do everything here. These are the AC controls, the airbag button, and some dummy buttons here as well. Up, this is the hazard light button. the gear lever, which we are not going to use today. We are not supposed to off-road in this car for now. 2 high, 4 high, neutral and 4 low. That's what we all want to use, but that's for a later day. That's the kind of storage you have. These buttons are kept here because the doors are removable, so the power window switches have to be here. It's not a cost-cutting sign, it's just how you do it. There's no other option. This is the kind of space that you have here, if you can see. Glove box, extremely small. This is a grab handle you're getting to hold on to stuff. There's carbon fiber finish here. I don't know why an off-road car has this here, but nevertheless, slide the seat back since it's not powered. These are steering controls for audio, phone and everything. This is for cruise control. To navigate through these menus here, you will have to press this button here. So if you can see, yeah, that's how you control it. And these are the buttons which control this function here. Yeah, so you get the idea. These are the stocks for your daily purposes. That's the seat. The speakers are mounted on the top also because the doors are removable, so they can't mount speakers in the door anymore. And since the roof is also detachable in the softboard version, this is the only permanent thing that is going to be staying here. Seats, I think they could be a bit more wider, but there is a decent amount of comfort that is on offer here. You sit quite high. The look from the cabin here is really something very extraordinary. The cockpit experience is going to be dramatic for a lot of people. And now let me show you what the rear seats are all about, which I'll have to go from the passenger side to show you what's it all about. So, yeah, so that's the kind of space you have here. Small adults can sit there comfortably for a long period of time. Yeah, yes, that's the lever you use to get things ahead, and that's the kind of space you have on offer. Again, you can do weekend drives, but I don't think you can go for really, really long journeys in this one. Although it depends on what kind of human size person will be sitting there. So they can be comfortable for even longer periods of time. No height adjustable seat belts. Got a lot of features in terms of infotainment. The most important question thing is right now is that how it drives. So let's find that out. We started driving a car in Mumbai city. We had limited time with the vehicle, and what we had with us is the 6-speed manual gearbox with the diesel engine. This is a completely redesigned 2.2 liter all aluminium diesel engine, and Mahindra has worked very hard on this engine, and it shows because the NVH levels are downright brilliant for a car of this size. And what it's always known for to being noisy, this is the entirely opposite of the previous generation car. It's very silent. The NVH levels are fantastic, even from the engine, from the road, from the wind noise that we could test while we did within speed limits of 120 kilometers an hour. Wherever we could do that, we found that the road and wind noise is also very well suppressed, and the engine noise just impressed us a lot. Despite it being an all aluminium engine, what Mahindra is claiming here, it makes 130 PS of power and 300 newton meters of torque, and those numbers are slightly lower than most of its siblings in the Mahindra portfolio, which have ladder on frame chassis and 2.2 liter engine. This is our first impression of a engine which is going to go into multiple cars. This is the 2.2 liter BS6 diesel, which is going to be the highlight of every single Mahindra car that is going to come in the future, and which is available on sale right now as well. And Mahindra has done a terrific job with the engine. The gearbox is so smooth, so light, so easy to use. The clutch is also very light. The signature low end torque, which impresses everybody with you know, any Mahindra vehicle, impressed us as well by a huge margin. There is torque from 1000 rpm to 3000 rpm. After that, it pretty much drops down abruptly. There is not enough power and torque above 3000 rpm. It does 120 kilometers easily, but we all know that the Thar is known for its off-road capabilities, but we were specifically told not to take it off-road for now, because that is going to happen in the next couple of weeks. We'll let you know more about it. That's when it happens. For now, I can say that the new stiffer, lighter ladder on frame chassis also has spectacular road manners. There is usually slight amount of pitching even on a smooth surface road, and you know, you kind of feel uncomfortable in the car. But here that has been extremely well controlled. Obviously, if you're a keen driver, you will notice that it's there, but it's bare minimum when you're driving around listening to music, navigating through traffic and everything, you won't even realize that. So I think Mahindra has done a great job in that aspect. It also gets good brakes. It gets disc brake at the front, but it continues to get drum brakes at the rear. But we found these brakes to be very, very good. Even the pedal bite, which is not Mahindra's strong point in terms of tuning, was pretty good here. It did not feel spongy or anyway. We had to hard brake multiple times in our Mumbai traffic all the way from North Bombay to South Bombay, and we did find the brakes to work really well for a car of this size, despite it has drum brakes at the back. Also, it has ABS, it has roll-over mitigation, it has traction control, it has a whole host of safety features with ESP, dual airbags, hill hold assist, and obviously child seat mountings and tire pressure mounting system is also part of the safety package. But the overall driving impression of the car has been very, very positive. The ride quality is also pretty good. It feels very mature thanks to a very impressive suspension system that is on offer with the Mahindra Thar, along with the lateral frame chassis that we just witnessed. It's a very good suspension setup. I think it's pretty mature. It feels compliant at lower speeds, just about compliant, but you do feel the underlying stiffness that's always been there. It feels far more stiffer than before, and that translates into great off-road manners on the road. Even at 120 km an hour, the vehicle was rock stable. It could change direction, change lanes without any hassle and without unsettling everybody in the car, and including the driver. Like I said, driving impressions also included that the seats are a little too small for larger people. I think the seats could have been a bit more better, but Mahindra says that these are sportier seats. But I don't think sportier seats are required here, but this should feel fit normal size adults and smaller size adults really well. But slightly larger, healthier people would find the seat comfort slightly on the lower side. You need to get used to the cockpit area to keep your hand and steering wheel and everything get together. It will take some time, but it will happen eventually, and that is a matter of days, not even weeks. What is also impressive is that there is a huge list of off-roading capabilities, hardware that has been added to the car. Like I said, we couldn't off-road it, but we can tell you the fact that it has a mechanical locking rear differential, electromechanical drive leg disconnect, which helps. It's basically all-wheel drive where you get 50% of the wheel power sent to the front or the rear wheels. There is always a brake locking differential, and like I said, the suspension is a double wishbone front with stabilizer bar, multi-link coil, rear suspension. So that also helps it become a better car. Sure, the Thar is a big leap forward for Mahindra. It's 10 times better than what the earlier Thar was. But what the Thar is right now is a Mahindra product, which we've seen recently, a step ahead of that as well. So that's the reason why Thar is gaining a lot of traction. We got multiple thumbs up and a lot of attention on the road, because the way it looks, the way it drives, and most importantly, the way it feels is much better than before. Over the previous generation, there's absolutely no comparison with the old one. But if you consider the new generation, Mahindra, the TUV, the XUV, well, it's even a step ahead of that. So that's the reason why Thar is going to gain a lot of traction. It's going to be launched in October. We can't wait to drive it again for more time. We can't wait to off-road it, and we'll tell you more about it. And stay tuned. We'll tell you more as soon as we get more information on that. So thank you so much for watching this video, guys. Hit that notification bell, subscribe to our channel, like this video, comment if you want to ask anything, and do not forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much for watching, and goodbye.